I'm sure you'd have come across Masterclass, a learning platform where the world's greatest experts and celebrities teach skills ranging from cooking, business, music to space exploration. I was really excited about this last year when this came out, and I took up the annual membership through which you gain access to all the courses for a period of 1 year. And since then it has been 8 months and I've only completed about 2 to 3 courses. So I decided to watch one course, at least one course every week, and summarize and share my lessons here. Hello YouTube, I'm Shakti, and today I'm going to discuss the few takeaways I had from Sarah Blakely's masterclass on self-made entrepreneurship. Now it is a 3.5-hour long course. Sarah Blakely was a fashion entrepreneur. She founded a company called Spanx back in 2000 and still in existence today. It generates an annual revenue of $500 million, and for the first 16 years of the company's existence, they did not have a single dollar of paid advertising. It was all word of mouth. Spanx originally started as a pantyhose making company. They made a particular kind of pantyhose and related hosiery garments. So basically they started with that, a pantyhose sort of a product, and then later diversified. Now they are into many other types of garments. Now I do not know Sarah Blakely or Spanx before I watched the masterclass, but after that I've also watched a few videos of Sarah Blakely, which kind of helped me tie up my lessons together. But watching this course reminded me of one of my favorite movies. I'll tell you what that movie is towards the end of this video. That movie is also about a woman-founded business that was also a fashion business. If you watch the movie, you should be able to guess it. So here are my 5 lessons from Sarah Blakely's masterclass on self-made entrepreneurship. Understanding the problem is more important than having business knowledge or industry experience. Now, Sarah Blakely's idea for this product and brand came from her own experience. She was working as a sales executive in the heat and humidity of Florida. She was selling fax machines door to door, and she wanted to wear white pants. Some of the garments require you to wear another layer of clothes inside. So pantyhose was one popular option, but the problem that she found was the pantyhose that was available in the market covered up to the toes. So it was seamed up to the toes. So there was no pantyhose that did not have a foot in it. So that was the problem she faced. So she understood the problem really well, and she knew that that was a problem that was being faced by millions of other women too. So she went about creating a product that she needed in her life and that would make her life better. She had not taken any business course until then, and she neither had any experience in the fashion business. Yet she went out and created a successful product. So that is why you'd not need business knowledge nor industry experience, but what you do need is a thorough understanding of the problem, and that comes mostly when you yourself have faced the problem. The second lesson is you got to get your hands dirty. You have to be the CEO, come salesperson, come the model. I was very surprised about this, and this is a lesson that I would take away very seriously, because when Sarah started out, she says that she not just focused on creating the product, making a brand, and then just selling to the distributors. She would go to the retail shop herself and stand near the sales shelf, and then she would herself explain the benefits to the customers, and she used herself as the model. Basically, she used her butt to promote and demonstrate the benefits of the product. So that's the point. You have to be the salesperson. Your job, you know, as a founder, as an entrepreneur, your job does not end with creating the product and, you know, creating a business strategy. You have to go there and be on the field, and initially you have to do this. You have to go there and do the sales and ensure that the customer get the product. And so that's the second lesson, that you have to get your hands dirty. And when you're starting out, no job is too small, and every little thing is very, very important. The third lesson is that your past experience and your failures give you unique skills. Now, Sarah, back when she was in college and she was younger, she wanted to be a stand-up comedian, and she used to do some open mics. But later she learned that, you know, she would never be a good enough stand-up comedian to as to make a good income from that. So she left that. But what she gained from stand-up comedy helped in her own business journey. What she learned from stand-up comedy was the importance of timing. She learned timing. She learned the importance of words. She learned storytelling. So all these skills helped in creating a brand story, creating a sales pitch, and convincing her manufacturers and distributors and ultimately her customers. She comes up with an amazing tagline initially that, "Don't worry, we've got your butt covered," which means that's what the brand was doing. And think about the name, the brand name Spanx. It's such a catchy name. It's basically a play on the word Spanx, and she adds X to it. And once you see it, you can never forget it. So these are the skills that came from her past experience of doing stand-up comedy, and these cannot be taught in a business class. The fourth lesson is that inspire with why and share your purpose. Now, Sarah had to face a lot of problems. She had to get her manufacturers in place. She has to find new distributors. She was just a brand that's starting out. So who's going to manufacture your products? Who's going to distribute your products? It's all difficult getting your first manufacturing distributors. And that's where she says, in every one of her conversations with her manufacturers and distributors, she shared her purpose and shared her why she was doing this, why she was creating this brand. Because this was to help women deal with her specific wardrobe problems and help make women's life easier. So that was a why for the brand. And that is what she used with her manufacturers and distributors to convince them to take her business. She had a powerful why. So it is not just about the economics and business. When you have a powerful why and share your purpose, that will inspire your other stakeholders in the ecosystem to support you and share your journey. Till today, she keeps talking about the why behind the brand Spanx, and I think that is why it has made Spanx very successful today. So this why is, if you remember or if you've heard about Simon Sinek's TED talk or his book Start With Why, it is very aligned with his talk and his idea that a business must have a why, and you must start with why. If you have a why, then there's more probability that you can get the how and what in place, and there's more probability that you will have long lasting success. So this brand and Sarah Blakely are completely aligned with Simon Sinek's idea that start with why. So this has taught me to start with why and share my purpose with others. The fifth lesson that I draw from Sarah Blakely is recruit the right fit and not just great CVs. Now, this was an interesting story I really liked. You know, Sarah Blakely is just starting out and she is looking to recruit one of her first few employees, and she meets this woman. They just meet somewhere in public. The woman is a customer of Spanx, and she was completely delighted by the product, and she goes on telling to Sarah about how this product is so great and how that has made her life amazing. So Sarah Blakely, out of the blue, offers the woman the role of PR head at Spanx. Now, that woman had absolutely no past experience in PR or corporate communications, but Sarah was totally convinced that that woman could do a great job because she was aligned with the brand and she was totally convinced about the brand. So those were the five lessons I took away from Sarah Blakely's masterclass on self-made entrepreneurship. Here's a quick recap. The first one is understanding the problem is more important than business skills or industry experience. The second one is getting your hands dirty and being the CEO come salesperson and model for your brand. The third one is that past experience and your failures gives you unique skills. Fourth is to inspire with why and share your purpose. And fifth is to hire the right fit than great CVs. So the course itself covers a lot more areas. It goes deeper into certain aspects. It has some case studies that on brands, Spanx, and even other brands. Sarah also mentors other brands in the course. There is also particular videos on pricing and positioning and creating brand awareness and building a culture. So the course is much deeper. These were just the five important lessons that I drew from that. But listening to Sarah Blakely's story and the story of Spanx reminded me of one of my favorite movies. It's The Intern, starring Anna Hathaway and Ben Whittaker. In that movie, Jules, who's the protagonist played by Anna Hathaway, is the founder of e-commerce company called About the Fit. And the way Jules runs the company is certainly aligned with the five lessons that I listed just now. So if you see in the movie, Jules herself would go and take some customer service calls. And she used to go to the warehouse and teach the women who are packing the orders, she used to teach him how to pack it so that it's a delight for the customers to open it. So she was certainly hands-on, she was getting her hands dirty, she was doing all the jobs, and she certainly had a strong why to why she was doing this business. She certainly had a purpose, and she knew her target audience really well. The movie is really inspiring, and if you haven't watched it, I would highly recommend it. So those were my lessons from Sarah Blakely's masterclass on self-made entrepreneurship. Next time, I'll meet you with another video. Goodbye, and thanks for watching.